Hello, everyone. We're on a Windows 2016 server where we will install remote desktop services, formerly known as a terminal server. We are on a Windows 2016 domain controller, but you can be on a regular domain member server or domain controller. Doesn't really matter. Let's go ahead and click on Add Roles and Features in our server manager and click Next. Now, we have the option to install role-based or remote desktop services. If we do role-based for RDS, then we'll have to just basically install it piecemeal. If we install this option, then it puts all of the different options that we need in at one time, which I like a little better. We'll go ahead and click Next. Now we have the option for standard deployment, quick start, or multipoint. So we're going to choose the standard deployment. And the quick start does do some shortcuts for you, but then you don't really learn anything. And then the multipoint services is usually for a different type of server, such as one that a school might use. Let's go ahead and click Next so we can start our installation. Now we have the option for virtual desktops, which is this first option here, virtual machine-based desktop deployment or session-based. So the difference is virtual desktop or virtual machine-based desktop deployment allows us to create a different virtual machine for every user that logs in. And we'd have to install Hyper-V as well. And so we're not going to show that in this video. We're going to do the session-based, and that's where everyone shares the same server, but they get their own customized desktop. Not as secure as virtual desktops, but definitely less expensive and faster to deploy. Let's go ahead and click Next. Here are the three remote desktop services that we're going to install today that will happen automatically. And these are the three minimum ones. We can install additional ones if we want. We can ignore all of them except for the session host if we want. But these are the ones that it wants to try to install at minimum. But I will go ahead and click Next and I'll show you how each one works. So we see the remote desktop connection broker service. And we'll go ahead and click that we want to add that service. And then we'll click Next. And then it's going to give us the option for the Internet Information Services or Remote Desktop Web Server. Let's go ahead and choose to install that as well. And we'll click Next. And same thing with the Remote Desktop Session Host Server. Now, this is the only one we really need, even though it shows us the three there. And that's because the session host server basically keeps track of all the sessions and manages them. Let's go ahead and click Next. And now we'll go ahead and choose, yes, you can restart the servers if you need to, and click Deploy. Now this could take anywhere from a few minutes, depending on the speed of your server, all the way up to an hour. So just go ahead and watch. As long as the bars are moving forward, then you should be fine. It is doing the installation process. And our server is now restarting. So it was successful. We'll wait for it to restart and then we'll log in and take it from there. And we've logged back into our server and it shows that all of our different roles were successful. Go ahead and click Close. Now I have remoted into the server using remote desktop. And one other thing that we need to make sure that we do is go into the control panel in order to allow this to happen and go to System and then Remote Settings and then make sure under the Remote tab you have Allow Remote Connections to this computer. Now, if you're connecting to a computer that's a member of the domain, you can check Allow Connections Only from computers running this NLA type of authentication. But if you're connecting from a non-domain computer, which what I'm doing, then you can make sure that you have that unchecked, otherwise you won't be able to log in. All right, once you have that set correctly, you can also click on Select Users. Now I'm only logging in as the administrator, but if you want to log in as other users, you can go ahead and search for those names now. That gives the right to log in using remote desktop to a server. Now you'll have to be a member of the remote desktop users group. So we'll go to Tools, Active Directory Users and Computers. And from here, we can go to and search for, we'll just type in remote. And there it is, remote desktop users group. And you can just go ahead and click members and you can add anyone that you want to that group and they'll automatically have the rights to get in. All right, so once that's done, now we're going to go to this new section here that wasn't there before. It says Remote Desktop Services. So we'll go ahead and click on that. Now, anything that has a plus in it means that it has not been configured. If it's grayed out, it means it's configured and ready to use. So if we go to the tasks menu, we can edit our deployment properties. We've already deployed everything, but now we want to edit it. So we've got here a remote desktop gateway and remote desktop licensing. Let's go ahead and start by clicking on the licensing, and we'll add our server that we're working with right here is as a licensing server. Now, by default, we're going to have about, I believe, 120 days automatically added for unlimited use. So as many as people as we want to have connected to it. After that, we'll need to add licenses into our licensing service. So once this is installed, then it's going to look to this particular server to get any remote desktop licenses, client access licenses, or CALs, we call them. And we'll go ahead and click close. And now you see this is grayed out because it has been configured. Now we have RD Gateway. So this is a little bit of a controversial type of role to add. So if you're going to be internet facing, then I recommend you use the RD Gateway, and you'll have to use a public certificate in order to keep people from getting certificate errors, unless you deploy the certificate using group policy, which usually isn't an easy thing to do for computers that are already in the field. So you can't get group policy applied unless you VPN in first. And if you don't have VPN turned on and the computers never get into the office, then you can never get that installed. So I would definitely recommend RD Gateway with a public certificate if you're going to be allowing outside users in. It does, the controversy comes in where it adds a lot of additional security, and sometimes it breaks things. So you can deploy this out on the internet without the RD Gateway role if you would like, and still use a public certificate. But I definitely recommend you add the gateway because it does add additional security. But we'll just go ahead and leave that off because we're only going to be accessing this from the inside or from the LAN. So there's no need to have that gateway additional security added in. However, I do want to go ahead and edit the deployment properties. So let's go ahead and choose this, and you see each one of the different roles as we go through. Now, we're not using a gateway, so once again, do not use an RD gateway is at the bottom, so because we did not click that green plus. So we'll just go ahead and choose the RD licensing. Now, we're going to choose the per user licensing is the most common, and the server we're going to pick is our Wind 2016 server. Now you can see it's already in there, so we don't have to do that. So we can just go ahead and apply that we're going to be doing a per user license. All right, now let's go ahead and go to RD Web Access. And you can see there is the RD Web Access server already installed because we chose that during the installation. And now we have certificates. Now there's no certificates configured there. In order to get this to work properly, we need our certificates. So I've gone ahead and created some commands that we can use to add certificates. So they're right in the root of our C drive. So now what we want to do is pull up a PowerShell command, and we're going to copy and paste that in. So we'll right click here, choose command prompt, and we'll type PowerShell, so it turns into a PowerShell prompt. And now we're going to copy and paste in this first command to start with. And now it's in there, we'll go ahead and hit enter, and it's creating a self-signed certificate, which is great. Now we need to put the next command that you see in here as well, so we can add a password to it. So by adding a password, it allows us to export the certificate in the future using the key export. So without a password, that doesn't work. Now you can see that the password is just password. Obviously, you're not going to want to do that. You're going to want to have something stronger than that. Okay, so that certificate is all set up. Now we want to go into MMC, Microsoft Management Console, just to confirm that the certificate's there. You can see it by going to Add Remove Snap-in. And from here, we'll go ahead and choose Certificate. There we go. Click Add. We want to choose the computer account and click Next, Local Computer, and click Finish. Now we'll click OK. And we should see our RDP certificate here. And there it is, RDP certificate. Fantastic. Now we're going to go ahead and right-click and export our certificate. So we'll choose All Tasks, Export. That's why you needed that password in there. And we'll choose Yes, Export the Private Key. And we'll just go ahead and choose a password. And we'll put in the same password that we used when we created it. and we'll click next. File name. We'll put it right on the desktop and call it RDP cert. Click save, next, and finish. And the export was successful. So now it's sitting on our desktop. So if you're unsure of that, we'll click on desktop, and there's our RDP cert successfully exported with the keys. Minimize that. Now we can go ahead and select that certificate by choosing Select Existing Certificate. We'll browse to our desktop, choose our certificate, and put in our password just to make sure that it's all secure. Allow certificate to be added to the trusted root authorities. Yep. Go ahead and click OK. And you see it's ready to apply. Go ahead and hit apply. Don't click OK. Click apply. And now it's going to apply. We're going to do the same thing to everything else that says level here. It says successful. Fantastic. Let's do the same thing again. And we'll choose our certificate, put in our password. Check the box once again, and apply. And we'll just go ahead and do that to each one of these until it's all done. All three of our role services have had the certificate added, and you can see the role RD gateway is set to unknown, and that's because we're not using it, so it's grayed out, and that's perfectly fine. All right, we've finished editing our deployment. We'll go ahead and click OK. So now we want to go in and go to Tools and then DNS, the DNS manager. Now, if DNS isn't on this server, make sure you go to the server where it is. And we need to add a host record for this RDP. So we added a certificate called RDP. So now we need to add a host record that points to it. So the name is going to be RDP. And so it automatically appends to rdp.widget.internal. And we'll put in the 192.168.15.251, which is the address of our server. We don't really need a PTR record, but you can add it if you want. And now it's been created and it's all done. So now from our clients, we should only have to put in RDP at the top, and it should be able to find the server right from there. Widget.internal, which is the name of our Active Directory domain. Click Enter. Now it's going to say, hey, the connection is not secure. That's okay. It's only because we're using a self-signed certificate. And we'll go ahead and click to confirm the exception. There we go. And so now we're in the server, but we haven't gotten into our remote desktop yet. So let's go ahead and do a forward slash rdweb. There we go. And now we should be taken, there it is, right into our remote desktop web version. So we'll go ahead and put in widget once again, backslash administrator, and we'll put in our password. There we go. And we're signed in. All right, so we haven't added any applications yet, but we know the web portion works, and we know the remote desktop portion works because I've actually logged into it as administrator. So let's go back into our server, and then let's set up the application so when we log back into here, we can go ahead and launch some apps. We're back in our server. Let's go ahead and go back to Server Manager, and then once again to our remote desktop services. And now we're going to click on Collections. Clicking on Collections allows us to add applications into our remote desktop web. Let's go to the top right where it says Tasks under Collections and choose to create a session collection. Let's go ahead and click there, click Next, and we'll just call it Test for now. Click Next, we'll add our server, Next. And we'll just go ahead and allow the domain users to have access. Click Next. And we can enable the profile disks if we want to have the profile settings in a centralized location. Don't really need that for this. We'll just go ahead and click Next. And we'll click Create. And we were successful. Go ahead and hit Close. And there is our collection. Go ahead and click on Test. And now we can add some applications. So we can publish remote app programs. Let's go ahead and add that. And it's going to show us a list of all the programs we can add for our web desktop. And take a look at all that. There's a lot of different things. Let's go ahead and add the calculator. And we'll go ahead and choose the remote desktop connection as well. So we can click Next and publish. And we're all set. Click Close. And now we have our two applications listed under Remote App Programs. Let's go back to our web version, log back in, and we should see those new apps ready to be used. I've refreshed our login, and we can see our calculator and our remote desktop connection, so that's perfect. Let's go ahead and launch the calculator and make sure it works okay. And it's prompting us to open with the remote desktop connection default. If we check this box, we won't get prompted again the next time around. Go ahead and click OK. Now, once again, we'll check that box so we don't get prompted again. Click Connect. And now we're being prompted to log in. That's okay. We'll go ahead and check the box to remember us. So a lot of extra prompting the first time we log in, but it shouldn't happen as much on the next time. And now we're waiting for the calculator to launch. And there we have it. Our calculator has launched. And if we want, we can go ahead and use it. Let's go ahead and click Connect. And now we're connecting using our remote desktop connection. And there we are. So we can see that both the calculator works and remote desktop connection works. And you can certainly go ahead and add in some additional remote app programs in our test collection. And when we're all done, we can go ahead and click sign out. So that is how we set up the remote desktop server and the web server, adding applications, all in Windows Server 2016. Now this also works in Windows Server 2012, as well as the new Windows Server 2019.